Well, after a few months, like, it was obvious that the monkey testicles wasn't working, was it?
Yes, it was as grossly fat as ever, weren't you?
So back I go to see Mr. Ribley. And he said, unfortunately, what must have happened, that I'd been given the testicles of a fat monkey. He said, if I liked, we could try again. But in his opinion, the better option was for him to give me a stomach transplant. So, naturally, I went along with him.
Why?
Well, he was a medical expert, wasn't he?
He was the medical expert who, by then, had, over a period of 5 months, and using some highly unpleasant techniques, consistently failed to help you lose so much as a pound in weight.
Yeah, but to be fair, I've been trying for nearly 30 years, and I hadn't got anywhere either.
So, Stephen Ribley persuaded you to have a stomach transplant?
Yeah. He said what I needed was a smaller stomach. And fortunately, he knew where he could lay his hands on one. So I had the operation.
And has it been a success?
No, not really. The trouble is, it's not a really settled stomach, if you know what I mean.
No, certainly isn't. He's had terrible wind ever since, haven't you?
Yeah. And you know what it's like. It's always worse when it's someone else, isn't it?
Monkey testicle implants, liposuction, beta masticane injections, and stomach transplants. Four controversial techniques regularly exploited by Stephen Ribley at the Ribley Body Clinic with no obvious success. Despite this, the Private Clinicians Professional Organisation, the British Private Consultants Association, continues to approve Stephen Ribley's medical practice. Why?
Look, to our knowledge, Mr. Ribley has consistently conformed to the very strict guidelines which are laid down in the Association's Code of Practice.
Yes, these guidelines appear to be solely concerned with preventing doctors from having sex with their patients.
That's right, which is very important, I mean, especially when you consider how much time doctors spend around parts of the body which are so often used for that purpose.
Yeah, but surely these guidelines are far too narrow.
Well, I'm surprised to hear you say that. I thought we'd covered every conceivable form of sexual confrontation. If you know of any others that we've missed, I'd be very willing to add them. Do you?
No, but there are a great many other questionable things that doctors might do to their unfortunate patients.
With
there?
Sexual undertones, you mean?
Not necessarily, no.
Well, then I don't quite see.
Well, they might, for instance, operate on someone for no good reason.
Well, that doesn't sound very erotic.
Or they might deliberately overprescribe drugs.
Aphrodisiacs, you mean? That's a popular myth, I'm afraid.
No, not aphrodisiacs, Mr. Franklin. Other kinds of drugs. Tranquilizers, sleeping pills, beta-masticane.
Oh, I see what you're getting at. Knock them out first, then jump on top of them. Well, we have had a few cases of that, I can't deny it, but it's very far from being a major problem.
No, look, I am not talking about sex.
Aren't you?
No. I'm talking about the fact that this man, Stephen Ribley, is clearly a danger to his patients.
Well, you can't discipline doctors for that. We wouldn't have any left.
The Ribley Body Clinic is only the most recent of Stephen Ribley's medical enterprises. His first venture in 1974 was into the so-called cryonic preservation of the chronically sick.
My aunt, well, she'd been ill for some time and we were worried about her. I'd heard about cryonics and how it was designed to preserve people till such time in the future as their illness could be cured. And then I saw this advertisement for Ribley's Cryonic Centre, which claimed it could freeze people fresher than any other company. Well, that decided me. I went in and paid my money, and they froze my aunt the following Monday. But 6 weeks later, when I went to visit, they said, unfortunately, the previous night, there'd been a power cut, and everyone had been defrosted.
Ripley next came to public notice 7 years later in 1981. This time, he was offering a baby surrogacy service.
Well, we wanted a baby for quite some time, hadn't we?
Yeah, that's right.
And you were biologically incapable of becoming pregnant?
Well, I don't know. Would you say I was, Stephen?
It's no use asking me. I left school when I was 15.
We don't know. Why?
Well, I just naturally assumed that you...
Oh, I see. No, it's nothing to do with that. I just didn't want to take the time off work.
I see. So you went to see a representative of Ripley's Babies Limited?
Yeah, that's right.
And?
He said that it cost us £10,000 per baby.
Right.
Or £19,000 for twins, or £25,000 for triplets.
Yeah.
Well, he recommended the triplets, didn't he?
Yeah. He suggested that we'd get together with another two couples and split a set of triplets three ways. But we didn't want to get involved with something like that.
No. So, what was the next stage?
Well, anyway, we decided to go it alone. And we saved up the money. And Stephen handed over a sample of his, you know, sperm.
Mm-hmm.
Well, it would have been more expensive if we'd have bought that as well.
Right.
Yes. So we paid them the money, we handed that over, and 9 months later they sent us this.
It's a hamster, isn't it?
Yeah.
How do you feel about that?
Well, we were very upset. We hadn't paid out £10,000 and waited 9 months for a hamster.
I did the spare room out as well.
You did? Did the whole spare bedroom out with Muppet wallpaper. To be frank, it's wasted on a hamster.
Ripley moved out of commercial surrogacy just before it became illegal and established this, the Ripley Body Clinic. During its 4 years in existence, it has treated several thousand patients. How many has it cured?
Oh, none.
He hasn't cured anybody?
Well, not intentionally, no.
In order to find out at first hand what kind of treatment is meted out at the Ripley Body Clinic, we've decided I should put on this disguise and become a patient here, pretending to be worried about my weight. Now, obviously, because I'm going to be examined by qualified medical people, I'm not going to be able to smuggle in recording equipment. This means I shall have to report to you when I come out. Right, well, here goes.
Well, here I am. I'm not feeling at all well. What's happened is... Oh, right. What's happened is that Stephen Ripley has operated on me. And inserted into my stomach too. Stephen Ripley has inserted into my stomach two capsules which have the effect of making me... have the effect of making me want to vomit.